At once the hot wind began to blow with redoubled force, and as Rashid sank into silent wretchedness, the greeny yellow mist with the toilet stink came rushing towards them across the lake, and the water was angrier than ever, slapping over the side of the swan boat and rocking it alarmingly from side to side, as if it were responding to Batu's fury. And also, in point of fact, to Haroun's growing anger at Batu's behavior. The mist enfolded the swan boat once again, and once again Haroun couldn't see a thing. What he heard were sounds of panic, the uniformed oarsmen crying, "Oh, oh, down we go!" and the infuriated shrieks of Snooty Batu, who seemed to take the weather conditions as a personal insult. And the more shrieks and yelps there were, the rougher the waters became, and the hotter and more violent the wind. Flashes of lightning and rolls of thunder light up the mist, creating weird neon-like effects. Haroun decided there was nothing for it but to put the moonland theory into practice. "Okay," he shouted in the mist, "everybody listen. This is very important. Everybody, just stop talking. Not a word. Zip the lips. Dead silence is very important. On the count of three. 1, 2, 3. A new note of authority had come into his voice, which surprised him as much as anyone. And as a result, the oarsmen and Batu too obeyed him without a murmur. At once the boiling breeze fell away, the thunder and lightning stopped. Then Haroun made a conscious effort to control his irritation at Snooty Batu, and the waves calmed down the instant he cooled off. The smelly mist, however, remained.